Okay, we got the machine empty. We want to take it apart. So this one was loose by hand, the fill cap. So we made a little tool to match it to get this one off. So it's not on there. Yeah, super tight. Now, we're pretty sure it's empty, but we still got some protection here just in case. So if it starts to run, we'll put it back in. But so far, so good. Okay. Before you take it all the way out, wiggle those threads. I don't think anything's going to come out. Yep. Got it. Now, I don't know whether this is the gasket that was leaking or this one is. So we're going to take them both off and give them a freshen up. Now, it's an old machine, so I don't know how long it's been since this one's been off. Now this one could still leak too, so be careful. All right, so we got it. Look at that. A little bit of goop. It is a grinder, so it doesn't feel gritty, but so those are some pretty nice big threads. There's a couple of gaskets to make here. And then we can button it back up and we're ready for fill. All right, so the gaskets are the pattern and we'll go make these two right here. Now let's also take off the sight glass because I'd like to get this clean so that you can see it better and also highlight these markers for fill, high-low markers. And this really can't leak unless you're filling it, so I really don't see a reason to take it off. All right, we're off. There it is. So we'll clean those two surfaces up super good and figure these out up on the table. Okay, so we took it all apart. We got it on the table, and let's diagnose it a little bit. This gasket's nice. It's been deformed a little bit. Probably wasn't leaking, but this wasn't very tight. It didn't take much. You guys saw it to get it off. Potential culprit. But this one, its gasket is very deeply dished. You can see it right there, like somebody's horsed on it to tighten it super tight. And it is clean around the backside. So this one was probably okay. So it looks like it's this guy right here. But from looking at the machine, the sight glass looks like they're staining on the side of the machine. And when you look at this gasket, there's oil right around this lower lip. And it looks like that hole is a little opened up. Not a big deal. but there's a lot of grunge here, and it also looks like this is probably where the culprit is on this side. So we need to make sure we seal the surface up really well. Also, one other observation. All the screws are the same except that one. That's the last one to come out. It's got a lot of gasket sealer on it. So it has the same number of threads as all the other ones. But it looks like somebody took this out, sealed it, and put it back in. That was likely this one. I can't really remember. But nice big thick sight glass. Let's see if we can pop this out of here. Now, you saw me rake this tool around the outside. A lot of times to take things off that have been painted once, you just need to scratch off the paint all the way around there and they'll come right off. So Amazon, your dentist, whatever, these are pretty handy for getting in the cracks. Let's check this out. And I'm not sure what kind of material this is, but it's not glass. Or if it is, it's pretty dirty. Actually, that's cleaning up pretty good. It might be glass. So let's be super careful with that. Let me grab one other thing right here. And let's yeah, this is the gasket sealer that's coming off. It's what was sealing up against the machine. Let's get a little bit more of that off, see if we can get it. Ah, here we go. Yeah. There it is. It's got a pretty big gasket around it on both sides. So we can totally replace this with a piece of clear plexiglass or polycarbonate, probably something that we don't think will crack, probably not polycarbonate. Don't know that I want to use a piece of glass either, but we'll get this replaced so we can see through it. And we need to make these three gaskets. All right, that's what it looks like. Looks like we found it. We'll fix it.